Good afternoon. Today we're going to make our first geological cross-section, a very simple one. As you know, any plane in the space can be defined by two main lines, okay? Which are the horizontal line. In any plane we have finite horizontal lines, and the line of maximum inclination. If I drop one ball, this is the path that will follow this ball, okay? So the line, the horizontal line, we call them the strike. And the line of maximum inclination, we call it the deep direction, okay? And they can be defined from a very unique single point, which is the geographic north, okay? If I have my north here in my right hand, okay, actually this strike will make an angle of about 135 degrees, right? And my direction will make an angle of 45 degrees. The relationship between the stripe and the deep direction is always 90 degrees. They have to be perpendicular. And then we have the deep, which is the degree of inclination of this plane. Okay, now the deep is 0, 90, 45, 60, 30, right? Okay, so once we have cleared these concepts, let's start with our cross-section. Here I have a very simple geological map. In this map, what we can see is that we have the topography, which is marked by these dashed lines, okay, which are marking the altitude, but we have this continuous contacts which represent geological layers, okay? Now I want to study which is the inclination of this layer, okay? Let's see the boundary between the layer T and S, okay? When I'm moving along this contact, I know that I'm always in the same plane, okay? So what do I have to do? I have to find points at a known altitude. That means if I'm always moving along this contact, and be careful because a common mistake is to switch with one contact to the other, I'm always moving along this line. Do you see it? Always moving along the same line. Let's see points at different altitude. Okay, let's start here. Here I'm at this line is crossing with this line, which is 500, okay? So this is a point of my plane with a known altitude, 500 meters. Let's continue. Here I'm at 600 meters. Again, a point of a known altitude. Let's continue. Always following the same plane, the same line, sorry. Okay, here I have another point. Here I say 600, sorry, this is 400. 400 and 400. I will continue here. 500 meters, again, you can see 500. This is the 500 crossing here. If I continue, I find another topographic point. This is 600 here, okay, and I here have 700, and again 700. Okay, so now I have a lot of points. I have 600 here, 700 here. I have to find points at the same altitude. So I will take my ruler and I connect points which are located at the same altitude. This is at 400, 400. So this and this are two points of the same plane located at the same altitude. So I can connect them using a line, okay? This is at 500 and this is a 500 as well. So I can connect them, these two also. Just taking a little bit of care. Okay, I have them. This is like 600, and again, I have one at 600. So I can connect them as well, because these are always points at the same altitude. And again, I have 700, 700, and again, 700 here. So I can connect this. Okay, all these four lines are connecting points at the same altitude. This is horizontal lines. So this is the strike. Okay, so this line is the strike of this plane. Okay, so in order to know it, I have my north located here. So I just have to use the protractor, mark the north somewhere parallel to the north. Sorry, put it this point. Put the north parallel to the north, and then I just have to measure the angle of this line, which is 84 degrees. Okay, the strike of this line, what we call also the delta, is 84 degrees, right? So, which will be the deep direction? The deep direction, it has to be perpendicular. But, so, it has to be something that is perpendicular to this line, in this direction or this direction. So, let's see which is the direction to which this plane is dipping. So we said that it was the strike of 700 meters. This is 600 meters. This is 500 meters. And this is 400 meters. So 700, 600, 500. This is going down to this direction. So the layer is dipping to the south. Right? So, the alpha, which is the deep direction, this is the strike, the deep direction will be 0.4 plus 90, 174 is the deep direction of this layer. So, what else do I have to do? I have to study which is the deep. For studying the deep, what I have to do is to measure. I will take one ruler. I will take one ruler and I will measure the distance perpendicular between two points. So let's see, they take these two points, right? So this distance is 37 millimeters. Okay, and we have one scale that is 1/20,000. That means 1 centimeter in the map, it's 20,000 units in the field. Okay, 1 centimeter in the map, it's 200 meters. If I have 37 millimeters, this will be 740 meters, right? Which is the difference of altitude between these two points? That was at 700, that was at 400. Let's draw very fast this triangle. Just marking this 37. This 37 millimeters, and the difference between 700 and 400 is 300 meters. 300 meters at this scale. This is 700 meters altitude. This is 400 meters altitude. The scale, okay, 1 centimeter, it's 200 meters, 300 meters, 1.5 centimeters, okay? This would be 15 millimeters, right? So, let's calculate beta. It's just, I can solve this triangle. It's 15 degrees, 37 inverse tangent. I will have one inclination of 22 degrees. You can do it in meters, you can do it in millimeters, doesn't matter. The inclination is always the same. So the depth of this layer is 22 degrees, okay? You can do it with these two distance, with two distance, but just remember that the difference of altitude will be the same. You have to find more or less always the same result. The wider you have, the less the mistake, right? So now I can just write the, let's see, let's start with the modern annotation, which would be 174.22, which is the modern annotation of this plane, or what would be the same using the classic annotation would be 0.8422. But okay, if you remember that you have to assign the direction of dipping, in this case is pointing to the south. Okay, so now I can mark as a result of this field that okay. So you can try it with this contact, you can try it with this contact, and in all the cases you find that it's the same. Again, following this contact, 200 meters, 200 meters, two points at the same altitude in an horizontal line. 300, 300, horizontal line. 400, I don't have it, but I know that all the horizontals are parallel. So I will run this parallel line. And again, if you measure this distance, it's the same as this, that this, that this. That means that all these layers are going to this pointing to the south, right? Now we're going to make the cross section. Okay, good afternoon. Now we have solved this map, now we are going to make the cross section. So, what do we have to do? First of all, we will take an auxiliary paper, like this, and decide which is our cross section. In this case, we have already solved this map, and we'll make the cross section from A to B, right? What I'm going to do is just using this auxiliary paper, will mark the same that topographic. First I have to do topographic. This will be the point A, this will be the point B, the ending of the cross section. I'll start first of all the topography. 400, have one line, another topographic line, another topographic line, and no more. This is 400, this is 400 again, 300, 200. Okay, so first of all, I use 1 millimeter paper. I start drawing my vertical and horizontal axis, right? This is the vertical axis and the horizontal axis. Let's put it here. Right? Okay. Remember the scale in this case was 1/20,000. That means one unit in the map, 20,000 in the field. So that means 1 centimeter in the map, it's 200 meters in the, it's 200 meters, right? If I start, let's say, at 800, 1 centimeter will be 200 meters. That means it will be 600, 400, 200, and this will be 0, right? I have my auxiliary paper. I'll put in the A point. This is the B. 400 meters around here. 400 meters here. This is very simple, right? I just have to connect the points, okay? Just making sure that when I connect the points, I cannot pass the 300 or be below. So I will make new, and it's going down, but I don't get the point of 200 meters, okay? This is the topography, okay? It's very easy. Right, now I'm going to, now I have the topography of this map. Now I have to put the geology. I will use one colored pencil in order to avoid mistakes. So here I have the contact, here I have this contact, here I have this contact, here I have this contact, right? So now I can come to my cross section and just mark this contact that will be here, here. Let's make it here. And this will be here. Okay, now I have to paint the layers, which was the direction. Okay, we have made the cross section from A to B. From A to B. That means A is in the north, B is in the south. So this cross section is more or less from north to the south. Okay, so which is the direction, the deep direction of this layer? It's pointing to the south. How much? 22 degrees. So what I would do is, I have this contact between this layer, between layer U and T. This plane is dipping 22 degrees to the south. So I will mark the point of contact in the surface. I will measure 10, 20, 2 degrees. And I only have to connect. Okay, I can cross the horizontal line because this is only for a reference, just helping me. Okay, again, the contact between T and S. Again, let's see, the boundary, the contact, this plane, remember, a line in a map is a plane, the plane between S and T. So it's dipping 22 degrees to the south. So go to the contact in the surface, mark 10, 20, 22, and I just have to connect it with this boundary between S and R is the same, or I could just go a little bit faster and draw a parallel line. And here, again, okay, this is the point B, this is the point A, this will be the layer U, which is outcropping in this part, this will be the layer T, this will be the layer, this thin layer, which is S, this is the layer R, and this is the layer Q. In this cross section, we don't cross the layer P, okay? So, that's it. Okay, now I could make the geological history. Which was the first layer to settle? First, we have the sedimentation of layers U, T, S, R, and Q. This is the older, this is the younger, okay? And after that, they were tilt or basculated. They were sedimented in an horizontal way, but somehow they were some tectonical effect, they get basculated. So after that, there was a tilting or basculation of the layers, and then erosion and actual relief. And that's it. Okay, just practice and see you soon.